Marshals did more than just stand around shooting, of course. Not everything blew up in the Calamity. Why Colford Cauldron here blew up way ahead of its time. The cauldron boiled over some 300 years ago. They say it filled the skies with ash and the lakes with molten rock. If you wanted to survive something like that, you had to learn to adapt. Best to keep out of the cauldron. It takes a certain stubborn pride to keep on living in a place like this. As for us, we learned an awful lot from Colford Cauldron. That learning led to some interesting inventions. The raw power of the world fell right into our hands. Playing with the cauldron's fires became an addiction. Can't fault our people for their natural curiosity now, can you? Sure, we dusted off a good many secrets out here. But we discovered other things we're better off not knowing. Taste the air so hot it sticks to your lungs. All sorts of awful things crawling underfoot. You can cook those things, but you can't eat them. Never thought we'd find so much life in all that ash. We kept on sifting through the cauldron's secrets anyway. The more ash we swept aside, the more life we found. Places inhospitable as they come. But still we pressed on. After all, when we look down inside Colford Cauldron, look down through all the smoke and flames. We saw in there the heart of the world, the heart now laid bare by the calamity. We had to have it. As for the kid, he just has to get that shard out of there. Too bad taking that thing woke up every last stink eye from here to Jocelyn Bog. Kid's thinking he's gotta trek all the way back around the cauldron. Luckily, the cauldron cooked up a little shortcut for him. Sure, it ain't the most convenient path. Biggest stink eye he's ever seen's waiting for him on the other side. Pops open on him like a pimple on a school day. But where there's one stink eye, there's always more. Cauldron's tenants all gather up to bid the kid a fond farewell. kid don't shed any tears for him, though. With a good spyglass, you can still see the cauldron from the city, but all the fires died out. There's nothing left of it. It comes back looking like the inside of a chimney. We're all a little short on friends these days, so that's a welcome sight. They said the wild could never be tamed, if only they could see us now. The shard works like a charm. You can hear the monument's heartbeat again.